Hello, I wanted to quickly record a post-tax season check-in video with everyone. The first quarter of the year has flown by. In our last video, I shared as we were kind of kicking off tax season that my wife was pregnant. And so I wanted to show y'all a quick picture of our new baby girl, Maxine. Here she is with her crazy hair. It just cracks me up, and life is so much better with her in it too. Thought I'd share that little personal piece with you. But I was able to take a quick paternity leave, and during our busiest time of year, and I'll forever appreciate that time. Many of our employees and clients gave us a ton of support and well wishes, and so that was so awesome. Made it go very smoothly. I had also shared in our kickoff video that we were going to be opening up another office in San Juan, Puerto Rico. And our family has since moved down here. We've hired our first two team members down here. Carlos, a CPA on our controller team, deep expertise in accounting software like NetSuite, Microsoft Power BI, and Bill.com. Camille, who's joining our integrations team, specializing in customer success. If you haven't met her, you will soon. And you'll call from one of our earlier newsletters, one of our associates, Deepa, laid out a lot of the important tax deadlines of the year. And so now that these two big ones have passed, this is another good check-in time, right? So we've potentially filed your tax return so far, but if we didn't have a tangible planning conversation, recapping that tax return for you and talking about things that you could be doing in 2022, let's do that now. We need to be able to explain these numbers to you to save more in taxes, hopefully to save you some time in gathering that data up, as well as potentially making more money. That's kind of the three prongs of what we try to do for our clients: save money, save time, and make money. To get the juices flowing a little bit, there were a few kind of common tax issues, tax opportunities, just things that clients and people were doing in 2021 that it's worth bringing up. So lots of rental properties came online this year, lots of new home purchases and home sales. And so if your vision may be acquiring like a rental property a year, or starting a property management business, or rehabbing and flipping properties, or raising debt or equity to go after commercial units, know that those are all trigger points to kind of talk to us about. So we can kind of share best practices of how to approach those from an operational standpoint, as well as a tax and accounting standpoint. For business filings, we saw a lot of expansion into new states in the way of sometimes it's hiring new employees or contractors. Sometimes it's just getting new clients or sales in different states, and you're wondering, do I need to file in that state? It's a piece of compliance that can totally keep you up at night and have potential, you know, other state governments kind of on the radar if you're not filing their state. So we've got to make sure that you're compliant with that. And some of our other clients were just opening offices like we were in other jurisdictions based on their organic growth or inorganic growth based on maybe acquiring a company. And so a tax planning discussion kind of is warranted if we see significant jumps from year to year in your net income specifically. So for example, if you did $100,000 in 2020 in net income from your business, and then that jumped to $300,000 in 2021, the tax planning discussions kind of totally change. The world opens up a little bit more in that world because we need to revisit entity structure depending on who you're hiring and where there might be opportunities and with that as well. Same thing if you're going from, say, $1 million to $2 million in net income. Those are just a small fraction of the issues that we were working with and discussing with clients. It just runs the gamut of everything that we're involved with. But I'd say a good rule of thumb outside of just, hey, Trevor, let's recap what the heck just happened. I know exactly what's going to happen in 22. If you have anything that, you know, gut feeling, it's keeping you up at night, or you're just unsure of, probably a good trigger point to shoot us a message. We can just give you our thoughts and our perspective. And we'll just kind of like touching base with our clients and understanding where you're at in this world of entrepreneurialism, or just the growth of your family and your jobs. And so we can kind of pull on other experiences, whether we're having them personally or from clients that we can confidentially help your transition in that world be a little bit smoother. So look forward to talking to you soon, and have a good one.